Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. Continuing on with your exploration into the effects environment, this video will highlight the alternative workflow of working above your edit when it comes to VFX and grading. Perhaps you prefer to build your effects and grading in separate stages. Or maybe for versioning purposes, you need to keep everything separated out instead of all in one segment. So you'll use gap segments in the sequence to achieve this. If you have not seen or used the effects environment before, I suggest going to the beginning of this series to give you a great start. Now this video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. So here you have an edited sequence that has minimal effects and some titles. Now in terms of organizing the edit, I have placed the titles on their own video track, and the main edit is spread over two tracks comprising of the bass and elements track. Nothing unusual about that. Now in all the previous videos highlighting the effects environment, you would select a segment and switch to the effects tab. This action applies any grading or VFX timeline effects directly to the segment. When you adjust the effect and switch back to the timeline view, you can see that timeline effects is part of the segment. This is the most common workflow for the effects environment. But as I mentioned earlier, there are some cases where you'd like to keep any timeline effects, grading or VFX, separate from the actual edit. So delete the timeline effects and let's start again. Now in order to grade or apply VFX above the main edit, you'll need another video track. Bear in mind that you'll want this track beneath the titles so that they are not affected in this case. Leave the focus point on the top video track to view all the tracks including the titles. Hold Ctrl and click on the track button to add a new track below the titles track. If the focus point shifts down to the new track, just drag it to the top again. Now you can go ahead and rename the new track just to keep a visual indication of what you're doing. If you select anywhere along this new track, you can see that it selects a single gap clip that spans the length of the sequence. In order to perform any grading or VFX, you need to duplicate the transitions of the bass edit to this new track. So call up the contextual menu over Video Track 1. Choose Copy Transitions to Track, and choose Video Track 3. If you start selecting the segments along the new track, you can see that the gap segments match the bass edit of Video Track 1. If you select any of the gap effects and switch to the Effects tab, you'll notice that the storyboard reel has built the edit from Video Track 3, but all the thumbnails have a gap indication. So you're working on the virtual gap clips which sit above the segments in the edit. You can start applying grading in VFX, and the user experience should be more or less the same as before. I just want to point out that since you are working on gap segments, your sorting modes are disabled. So you can't sort by tape name or time code, simply because these virtual clips have none. However, you can still filter clips by selection or search criteria. At any point, you can switch down to the bass edit on Video Track 1. But we don't want to do that in this case. Now you can jump to different gap segments by clicking on the thumbnails in the storyboard reel. But I also want to suggest changing the time bar mode as well as the viewer mode. Switch the options from segment range to timeline range, so the entire timeline is accessible in the time bar. Next, change the viewport from result to primary track. This will show all the tracks in the context of the effects tab. So if we select the second thumbnail in the sequence, you can see the title track above the gap clip, and you can apply whatever effect you want. For example, let's create a look. Using the first selective, drop the saturation, decrease the offset, and increase the gain. Finally, drag the color wheel towards red. Toggling between the front view with F1 and the primary context view with 4 allows you to see the before and after. Now let's add a second selective. Hold space and click on Selective 2. In the file browser, choose the Glow Selective Effects. To limit the selective with a mask, call up the contextual menu over Selective 2 and choose Ellipse. Draw the shape to cover most of the image. Now press F4 for the result view and select the mask. Click the Invert button. Next, add a gradient through the contextual menu and soften the mask. Toggle 4 to see the primary track contextual view. So that's our look development, and it doesn't affect the white title, which sits at the top track above the edit. Now let's apply this look to all the segments. Hold Ctrl and select all the other thumbnails in the storyboard. Drag the image timeline effects to the secondary selection. So all the shots now use the same look, but you can still go through any of these shots and tweak them further. Now all this time, the workflow in the effects environment should feel the same as before. But if you switch back to the timeline view, this entire time we've been working in the virtual gap clips above the edit. If you wanted to disable these effects, you can just mute the track, and there are the original segments. So you could apply individual effects to specific segments, and then use another track above the edit to do even more effects, whether it's the entire timeline or specific segments again. For example, if you were versioning different grades, you could have multiple tracks with different looks, and you can turn them on and off to try different treatments. It's quite a flexible workflow, and hopefully adds to what you can already do with the effects environment in the timeline. More effects environment videos coming soon. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.